kasokoma liba kazobre kede mazobre kadosh kelebra kadosh alabaraba yanda la boshi karia dosh kelabar yanda losha pero dosh te kebra kadosh alabar yanda la bo kelaba koseta la bra kadosh kelebe diasa talaba ya kabroshi ke diaseta la bariga dosha karabarabo Mere ke dosha kabre ke doska labra dosha yaba mazu pre ke doska labra kadeshe keri yarabarabo yaraba kasoko be ke dia soto toko bori atakaba li ke dosha kabra doske le be dia satala baraba yarabo koshe keri yarabariando se ke dia radada. Thank you Holy Spirit, thank you Holy Ghost, thank you Holy Ghost. Thank you, my Lord. I worship you. I give you glory. I exalt you. I bless you, Lord God. You are worthy of glory. You are worthy of honor. You are worthy of adoration. Receive praise, O God. We worship you. We exalt you, my God, this morning. You are a great God. You are a good God. Thank you for thy message. Thank you for your loving kindness. Thank you for your faithfulness upon our lives. We give you praise. We give you praise. We give you glory. We give you honor, my God. Receive you the glory in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you so much, oh God. Thank you, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Thank you for your presence. Thank you for your glory. Thank you, my God, in the name of Jesus Christ. We give you praise. We give you honor. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen and amen. Greetings, greetings, people of God. Glorious day to you. I want to greet you wherever you're watching me from. You're welcome. Thank you for taking your time to join in this broadcast. I want you to invite your friends quickly. So that we can continue with our service. And it's a good day. It's a glorious day. God has something special for us today. And I want us to take time to hear the word of God. So I just want you to, in a very quick and brief moment, just invite friends, share the broadcast. Share the broadcast. Yes. Just share the broadcast. I thank you. I thank you for taking your time. Thank you for taking your time. Yes, it is well. 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 Okay. All right. All right. Okay. That's all right. We thank God. Let's get straight to the business of the day. We want to get into the Word of God this morning, and God allowing us, let's see how far we can go. But today I want to speak about something that I believe it will impact your faith. The title of my message is simple: Become a God to your situation. Become a God to your situation. So I don't know what situation you are facing right now. Everyone is facing a situation one way or the other, different diverse kinds of situation. But my message today is become a God to your situation. So I want us to get into the word of the Lord, and let's discuss from the word of the Lord as we tackle this issue. And I believe the Lord will bless us as we hear the word of God. Let's come to the book of Exodus chapter 7. Exodus chapter 7. Exodus chapter 7. Come to Exodus chapter 7. I am going to take my reading from verses 1 through 3. Okay. Come there. All right. I'm going to read here. And the Lord said unto Moses, See, I have made thee a God to Pharaoh, Take note of that. And Aaron thy brother shall be thy prophet. Oh my God. Verse 2. Thou shalt speak all that I command thee. And Aaron thy brother shall speak unto Pharaoh, that he sent the children of Israel out of his land. Verse 3. And I will harden Pharaoh's heart, and multiply my signs and my wonders in the land of Egypt. Oh my God. All right. Let's also look at Exodus chapter 9. Exodus chapter 9 verse 16. Exodus chapter 9 verse 16. All right. He says here, In very deed, for this cause have I raised thee up, for to show in thee my power, and that my name may be declared throughout all the earth. So God is speaking about Pharaoh here. He says, and in this very deed, for this cause have I raised thee up, for to show in thee my power, and that my name may be declared throughout all the earth. All right. Let's go to the book of Psalms. We're just going to do our reading. Then we'll talk at once. Let's come to the book of Psalms chapter 82. Psalms chapter 82. All right. The book of Psalms chapter 82. All right. Here we go. 82. I'll take my reading from verse 6. Verse 6 says, I have said you are gods, and all of you are children of the Most High. I'll take it again. I have said you are gods, and all of you are children of the Most High. Wonderful, wonderful. All right, let's also come to John. John chapter 10. John chapter 10, verses 34 to 35. All right. 34 to 35. Verse 34. Jesus answered them, it is written in your law, I said you are gods. Take note of that. Jesus answered them, Is it not written in your law, I said you are gods? 35. If he called them gods, unto whom the word of God came, and the scripture cannot be broken. Let me take it again. Jesus answered them, is it not written in your law, I said you are gods? If you call them gods unto whom the word of God came, the scripture cannot be broken. Wonderful, wonderful. Mark chapter 11, Mark chapter 11, Mark chapter 11. All right, Mark chapter 11, verse 22. I want verse 22 there. Mark chapter 11, verse 22. Here we are. 22 says, and Jesus answering said unto them, have faith in God. Have faith in God. Our last portion of scripture, Genesis chapter 2, verse 2. All right. Genesis chapter 2, verse 20, I mean. All right. And Adam, all right, let's start on 19 actually to get the whole sense of the text. And out of the ground, the Lord God formed every beast of the field and every fowl of the air, and brought them unto Adam to see what he would call them. And whatsoever Adam called every living creature, that was the name thereof. And Adam gave names to cattle, to the fowl of the air, and to every beast of the field. But for Adam there was not found any help meet for him. God bless the reading of his word this morning. Okay, so we read here from the book of Exodus. Remember, I said I want to talk about be a God to your situation. Now God is talking to Moses and Aaron here. And God is saying to Moses, look, today I've made you a God unto Pharaoh, and Aaron shall be your prophet. You shall go and speak to Pharaoh, But I am going to harden the heart of Pharaoh, oh my Jesus. I have made you a God and a Father. I need you to see here that God is talking to Moses about Pharaoh, who was a very, very difficult king to deal with. In fact, God is even saying to Moses, I have hardened the same Pharaoh's heart, but I have made you a God and a Pharaoh. Oh my Jesus. I have made you a God and a Pharaoh. What is the meaning of this? Moses, I have given you charge of Pharaoh. I have made you to be a God. In other words, you need to be a God to Pharaoh. You need to tackle Pharaoh. When you look at Pharaoh, difficult as he is, hard-hearted as he is, you need to position yourself as a God. You need to operate with Pharaoh as a God. You should not be intimidated by Pharaoh, because you shall be like a God unto Pharaoh. You should not be afraid of Pharaoh, because you shall be a God unto Pharaoh. Oh my God, I don't know the Pharaoh that you are facing. The Pharaoh here can be your situation. You may regard your situation that my situation is like a Pharaoh kind of a situation. What is a Pharaoh kind of a situation? This is a situation that is very hard. God has said to Moses, I have hardened the heart of Pharaoh. He is a hardened a king with a hard heart. But you shall be a God unto Pharaoh. I want to speak to you, child of God. What kind of Pharaoh are you facing? You may say to me, man of God, I think my situation is a Pharaoh kind of a situation. This is a situation that is very hard. This is a situation that when you pray, sometimes there is no change. When you fast, sometimes there is little change that you see, or no change at all. When you do something about your situation, it seems like it's not shifting. It seems like there is no change at all. There is no movement. That's a Pharaoh kind of a situation. But God is saying to you this morning, be a God under that situation. Remain steadfast. Confront that situation. Keep your solid front. Do not be intimidated by that Pharaoh situation. Be a God under Pharaoh. God said to Moses, today I have made you a God. Oh my Father, God is saying to you, I have made you a God in that situation. Why are you complaining? Have you seen God complaining? Have you seen God grumbling? Have you seen God stressed? God cannot stress. Why are you stressing? God is saying, I have made you a God in that situation. And God acknowledges that the situation may be hard. He said to Moses, yes, I am going to harden the heart of Pharaoh. I am going to make his heart hard. But you must be a God unto Pharaoh. You must not be afraid of what Pharaoh is going to say. Remember, Moses went to Pharaoh several times. He was humiliated. He was embarrassed before the servants of Pharaoh. He was ridiculed and mocked. But God said to Moses, you shall not be moved by his words. You shall be a God to Pharaoh. Even if he insults you, you shall be a God to Pharaoh. Your situation may be looking so bad. It may be a Pharaoh kind of a situation. But God says, you shall be a God to that situation. It doesn't matter what the situation is saying to you. Maybe your situation is speaking to you right now. It is showing you that there is no hope. It is showing you that there is no way out. It is showing you that you are trapped forever. Remain a God. Be a God. Talk like a God in that situation. How does a God talk? God does not complain. God does not beg. God does not sing a song of misery. God, he decrees and declares. God commands. Remember the language of God. You as a God must talk the language of God. Oh my Father. You as a God must speak like God. You must open your mouth as a God. What did God speak? What is the language of God? Let me just give you some information. Let me just give you a brief information of the language of God. How does God speak? When you go in the book of Genesis, you find that the Bible says there was darkness. There was darkness. The earth was without form, and darkness covers the face of the earth. This is not just ordinary darkness. This is gross darkness where you cannot see yourself, where you cannot see something next to you. But the God began to speak. He began to say, let there be light. Oh my God, hear when God is talking. Hear when God is talking. He does not mind the gross darkness. He is not moved by the gross darkness. He is not intimidated by the gross darkness. He just rise up and begin to say, let there be light. And the Bible says, light was there. And behold, it was good. I want you to talk like a God. You are trapped in a situation. You are in sickness. Speak like a God. Rise up like a God and begin to declare the end from the beginning. Yes. Begin to declare what you want to see. Begin to declare what you desire. God never spoke about his darkness because he didn't want to see darkness. God never spoke about the voidness, the void, the state of the earth. He just declared what he wanted to see, and it was good. The Bible says it was good. As a God, declare what you want to see. Lord, I have made you a God in that situation. That says the Lord God. This message is not unto Moses alone. This message is also unto you. I have made you a God in that situation. Are you facing debt? God says, I have made you a God. You speak unto that situation as a God. Speak unto that situation as a God. Declare in faith, oh my God. Declare in faith, oh Jesus. The Bible says that when we read in chapter 9, God says, I raised you, Pharaoh, for this reason. If you read in the New Testament, the Bible says, for this cause I have raised the Pharaoh, so that I may show forth my power. God has raised the Pharaoh in your life, so that he may demonstrate his power.
Amen.
If you don't face difficult situation, you will not see the power of God. If you don't face tough situation, you will never experience miracles. Miracles and wonders are seen to people that are ready to go through things. You can never experience God when you are in your comfort zone. Why did God take them through the wilderness? The Bible says they were supposed to take 11 days to go to Canaan, but God says go through the wilderness. Why? He wanted to show them his power. He wanted to show them that water can come out of a rock, not from the sand, yes, not from the swamps. Water can come out of the rock. Lord, of all things, the rock is the hardest thing. God said, I want water to come out of the hardest thing, yes, to show you that I am God. Oh my God, God wants to show you he can deliver you from that situation. He has brought you in that situation. He has allowed that situation to come your way because he wants to show you that his power. God wanted to show them they can eat bread even where there are no bakeries. God wanted to show them they can eat meat where there are no butcheries. They can eat bread where there are no bakeries. Oh my God, oh my God. For this cause I have raised the Pharaoh so that I can show forth my power. For this cause I have raised the Pharaoh. God has raised the Pharaoh in your life. That situation is a Pharaoh. Why is this Pharaoh facing you? Why am I facing these Pharaohs? Maybe some of you are facing multiple Pharaohs because God wants to show his power. You are about to see God's power, my brother. You are about to see God's power, my sister. You are in that situation because God wants to show you his power. Do not panic. God has made you a God. The Bible says, I have made you a God today. Meaning to say, Moses, you shall not have a chicken heart. When you stand before Pharaoh, don't have a chicken heart, because today I have made you a God. Thus says the Lord God of Israel. Today, rise right now. Begin to operate like a God. In that situation, you are a God. In that situation, you are a God. In that situation, you are a God. What does the Bible say in the book of Psalms? The Bible says, have I not told you that you are gods? Don't you know that you are a God? Why are you gods? Because you are offsprings of God. You have the DNA of God. You are made from God. You came from God. You are not an ordinary being. Oh my God, you are not an ordinary being. Hear me. You are not an ordinary person. You are a God. He said, you are gods, you children of men. And Jesus was speaking with the Pharisees when they said, why do you really make yourself equal to God? Why do you really declare yourself the Son of God? Jesus said, you people, you don't understand the scripture. Have you not read in your law? It is written that you are gods. If he called them gods, those who declare the word of God, how much more us who have Jesus Christ? How how much more as yes. will of the Holy Ghost. He has made them gods. You are a god. You have been living like a man. This is the error that people make. People say, I am a man. You are not a man. You are a god. They say, I am a man. Oh, I'm in the flesh, you know. I also am a man. But I want you to know, don't operate as a man. Demons are not afraid of a man. Yeah. Operate as a god. Operate as a god. We read in the book of Mark. I just want to bring these scriptures to you. In the book of Mark, the Bible says, have faith in God. Mm. Do you understand? The Bible was talking about mountains. Jesus said, have faith in God. What had happened? Jesus had spoken to a fig tree. And the fig tree dried from the roots to the top. And the disciples were amazed. They said, Master, the fig tree that you have cursed has dried. And Jesus said, have faith in God. Amen. That is not the original script. The original script says, have the faith of God. Have the faith of God. In other words, when you are standing before that mountain, have the faith of God. Yes. Operate in the godly dimension. Yes. Operate in the faith of God. Yes. God has allowed us to operate in his faith. He has allowed us to operate in his faith. Why? Because he has placed us on this earth to rule and to reign as gods, not as men, but to rule and to reign as gods. Oh my God, have the faith of God. Operate as a God. You are God. Jesus said, you are God. You are God. God says, I made you God, a God unto Pharaoh. You are a God. You are complaining, but you are a God. You are complaining, but you are a God to that situation. You are crying about that situation. You are a God to that situation. You are a God to that situation. It doesn't matter how bad it looks. It doesn't matter how difficult it may seem. You are a God to that situation.
Glory.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God. The Bible speaks of Adam. I like it. God, the Bible says, when God had created things, God felt like, why should I have a day? Why should I do a job of naming these animals? After all, I'm not the, there's another God on earth. The Bible says God brought them to Adam and he presented the animals to Adam to see what he shall name them. In other words, God brought them to Adam and he waited so eagerly. He waited eagerly to see how the man that he had created was going to operate just like him. And the Bible says Adam began to name them. He began to declare them their names, and whatever he declared it was so.
Yes.
Oh my God, whatever he said was so. If he said it is an elephant, it was an elephant.
Yes.
If he said it is a lion, it was a lion. I'm sure God was so amazed by this dimension. Mm. God was so amazed when Adam was living like a God man, when Adam was operating like a God. God was watching as he was naming things. Mm. Whatever he names was coming, became so. Whatever he said, it was established for ever. It was established forever.
Yes.
All I want you to say is, what are you naming that situation?
Yes.
God is bringing the situation to you. He wants to see how you're going to name that situation.
Mm-hmm.
How are you going to name that situation? Whatever you name that situation, it will become. Whatever you say to that situation, it will become. God has brought those things before you. He wants to see how you're going to name them.
Yeah.
He brought the animals before Adam so that he would see how he was going to name them. If he said this is a snake, it became a snake. If he said this is a lion, it became a lion. How are you going to name? What are you naming that situation? What are you naming that situation? What are you saying to that situation?
Hey.
God wants to see what you are going to name them. God wants to see what you're going to say to that situation. Rise up, begin to speak to that
God.
Situation. Begin to speak to that situation.
Yes.
Begin to declare as a God. Begin to speak the good things that will make you happy. He wanted to see what he was going to name them.
Mm.
And he was amazed by what God Adam was doing.
Mm.
He was amazed when he saw Adam beginning to name. Adam is operating as a God. Have I not said to you, you are God? You are God. I have made you a God. Have the faith of God. Operate as a God. You have been operating as a man.
Yes.
This is why you're facing defeat. You confront your challenges as a man. You talk as a man. You reason as a man. You perceive as a man. You don't perceive as a God. When you see Pharaoh, you must know it is an opportunity to experience the power of God. And God says, when I will multiply my size,
Why? In Egypt. So that if you want to see multiplied signs, you want to see multiplied miracles, then there must be a Pharaoh. Then you must be able to confront a Pharaoh. Allow that Pharaoh to come. Allow that Pharaoh to come in your life. If you are going to see the power of God, do not grumble. Because it is an opportunity to see the power of God.
Yes.
Have the faith of God. Have the faith of God. He brought the animals to see what he was going to name them. What are you naming the situation? God has brought that situation before you. He wants to see how you're going to name it. And whatever he named, it was established.
Yeah.
You are operating as a man. You are reasoning as a man. You panic as a man. But you are a God. Don't panic. Don't listen to what your situation is saying. You are a God. Begin, remain steadfast. Remain steadfast. Keep your solid front. Even if you are praying and there's no change.
Yeah.
Even if you are declaring and there's no change. Some of you are declaring. You're declaring, but you are not seeing any change. And you give up. Don't give up. Don't give up. You are a God. Remain a God. Just begin to say, I am in control. I walk with a great God. You mountain, you shall be removed. Oh my God, this mountain shall be removed. This mountain shall be removed. Not by might, not by power, but my spirit, says the Lord. Remember what the Bible says in the book of Zechariah. Who art thou, you great mountain, before Zerubbabel? Who art thou, you great mountain, before my life? You shall be reduced to a plain ground. I see that mountain reduced to a plain ground. Because you are a God, I see that mountain reduced to a plain ground. Because you are a God, operate as a God. Change your mind. You are a God. You are not a human. You don't speak and say, I am human. You believers are not just human. Yes, I am a human. No. You are a God. You are no longer alone. Remember, Christ is in you. You are in him. You are hidden in him right now. You are no longer just a human being. Oh, hallelujah.
Glory.
I have made you a God unto Pharaoh. I have made you a God unto Pharaoh. That says the Lord. I have made you a God in that situation who is going to bring solution. You are waiting for other people. You are waiting for God. Yet he has made you a God in that situation. You are crying to God. Yet you are a God in that situation. You are complaining. Yet you are a God. Come on, rise up. Look what God did in Genesis. It was him demonstrating to us what we need to do. When he found the earth without form. When he found the earth void. When he found the earth inhabitable. What did he do? He didn't cry. He had no one to cry to. He is God. He is himself. He is himself. There is no other. He looked and he realized that if I don't do something about my situation, no one else. He began to say, let there be light. He begins to say, let the water separate from the ground. He begins to say, let the earth bring forth the herbs and the green things. And it was so beautiful. Oh my God, you are a God. Do not wait for someone to come there. Have the faith of God. Operate with the faith of God. For this cause, God has raised that Pharaoh in your life. So that he may demonstrate his power. Are you about to see, you want to see God's power? You want to see God's power, then you need to have a Pharaoh. If you are going to see God's power, there must be a Pharaoh. Otherwise, there is no multiplication of signs that's going to happen. God, people of God, I want to thank God for the word. I believe. I can see your faith is uplifted.
Yes.
I can see you're so encouraged. Yeah, praise God. I can see you are charged in the spirit. I can see you are ready to confront every mountain. I can see you're feeling in your spirit that nothing shall stop me. Yes, for sure, you are unstoppable. Nothing can stop you. You are a God. You are a God. You are the offspring of God. In him you move and you have his being. Today I want to pray with you. I want to pray with you. You may say, man of God, I'm so discouraged. Man of God, the Pharaoh that I'm facing, I need the reinforcement. Let me be a reinforcement to your prayer. Together, we can move that mountain. Together, we can cast out that demon that is troubling your life. Together, we can stop that negative thing happening in your life. Together, we can stop the nightmare. I want to be your partner in prayer. Let me partner with you in prayer. Together, we can pray and release the miracle you want. Together, we can entreat God for your situation. Are you ready to pray?
Amen.
I want you to agree with me as I pray for you. I'm declaring things, and those things are going to happen. As I declare things, remember, we are gods. We declare, we decree, and whatever we declare and decree is established upon our lives. Do you want a breakthrough right now? Do you want a miracle that you want right now? I hear in my spirit, there's going to be a this week there will be a release of miracles. This week, God is going to release some great miracles upon his people. I want to pray this week that God is going to do something, move something in the realm of the spirit for you. Oh my God, stretch your hands. Let me pray for you. Father, I release that power. Lord God, yes, you have made us gods to reign and rule in this earth. I pray for your people right now that are watching, those that shall watch. Father, I pray in the name of the Lord Jesus. Lord God, with this revelation, raise them to operate, Lord God, in their position. Raise them to operate in their capacity, in what you have designed them to be. You have made them gods in their situation. You have made them gods to that Pharaoh they are facing. Whatever Pharaoh they are facing, God Almighty, I declare and I decree, they are overcoming. I decree and I declare, they are conquering. In the name of Jesus, they are conquering. These ones, Lord, are conquering. They are conquering every battle. They are winning in the name of Jesus. They are rising like a mighty army, like a mighty great army. Lord God, they are taking over territories. They are subduing my Father in the name of Jesus. Mountains are being removed. I command mountains to be removed. I command mountains be removed. Be cast in the sea. Mountains of death be removed. Be cast in the sea. Mountains of discouragement be removed. Be cast in the sea. Mountains of lack be removed. Be cast in the sea. Every mountain of sickness be removed. Be cast in the sea. In the name of Jesus, whatever mountain, whatever Pharaoh they are facing, Lord, I declare victory, 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 victory in the name of Jesus Christ. It is happening. The power of the Lord is touching your case right now. Angels are released. Angels are released. Angels are dispatched right now. Angels are released to fight your battles. Warfare angels. They are released right now on your behalf. I release that breakthrough. I release that miracle. I release that breakthrough. I release that miracle. I release that answer. I release that breakthrough. Breakthrough in your finances. Breakthrough in your marriage. Breakthrough in your career. Breakthrough in your business. Breakthrough in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Whatever you are desiring, whatever you have been praying for, some of you have been praying for many years. You have not seen the answer. I release the answer right now. Amen. Whatever blessing has been hijacked, demons have hijacked the answer. Right now, I release the answer. I release those prayers that have been hijacked by demons. I release your angel that is supposed to come to you. It is hijacked in the realm of the spirit. In the name of Jesus, I stand in authority. I release them in the mighty name of Jesus. Miracles, miracles upon your life. Miracles, miracles, miracles over your life. Miracles. The anointing of the Lord is rising upon you. I see God's people rising. I see God's people moving in power, moving in authority. I see you standing in your house declaring things and the things happening. I see you taking charge right now. I see you are rising in faith. I see you are rising in power. I see you are declaring things and things are happening. Oh my Jesus, there is an anointing. There's an anointing coming upon God's people. There is a revival that is taking place in your life. In the name of Jesus Christ, somebody's going to release that phone call. Receive that phone call that will make you smile. Receive that message that will make you smile. That email that will make you smile. Oh my Jesus Christ. Oh God, I see mountains moving right now. Oh my God, I see people rejoicing. I see you testifying. I see you giving a testimony. I see you testifying. Oh my God, your prayer life is changing. You will not pray the same way. Now you are going to pray like a God. Now you're going to talk like a God. Even when you just look at things, you will just look at things and declare. pray and those things shall be so. Yes. God's people, you are blessed. You are blessed. You are blessed. Amen. I see someone, you are feeling heat in your hands right now as I pray. There is heat in your hands. That's the healing power. God is granting you the healing power, the healing anointing. You shall declare a word of healing and people shall be healed. They will jump out of their bed. Miracles shall follow. Oh my God, we are in the era of the glory. Remember, it's our year of greater glory. It's our year of greater glory. Let there be greater glory wherever you are. Yes. People of God, greater glory. Greater glory in the house. Greater glory wherever you go. Greater glory wherever you go. Greater glory wherever you go. In the name of Jesus Christ. Oh my Jesus. Oh my Jesus. I feel the power of God. I feel the power of God. I feel the power of God, people of God. I just want you to continue in the attitude of prayer throughout this week. It's a week of wonders. It's a week of wonders.
Thank you, Lord. It's a week of wonders.
I perceive. It's a week of wonders. It's a week of wonders. Somebody, you are being shifted by God right now. Somebody, you're being shifted by God. Your spiritual life is not going to be the same again. I see someone here. Your dream life has been affected. Your dream life has been affected. You were dreaming, but now the dreams are going. Some of the dreams you can't even remember. Some of the dreams are being stolen. I perceive someone, your dreams have been stolen. Your dream life is restored.
Thank you. Write down.
God says, write down. Write down those dreams. You will dream things and God will tell you a lot of things. Write down. You have a book of dreams. Oh my God, you are so blessed, people of God. You are so blessed. I see someone here. You are so blessed. Be healed from that the problem with your leg. Be healed. Someone, your backache, be healed in the name of Jesus. Healing, 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 healing in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. God's people, you are so blessed. Thank you so much. I have to leave you. I have to leave you. I don't want to keep you for long. God bless you. God bless you. All of you that are watching here, it is well with you. It is well with you. Yes, men of God and woman of God, you're welcome. Pastor Mbiza and your wife, you're welcome. Maslin, you're welcome. Yes, my Anguchwara, my elder, Kaza, you're welcome. Yes, everyone that is watching here, you are welcome. God's people, you're blessed.
Amen.
I speak a personal blessing over your lives. You people, may God bless you. May God grant you. The desires of your heart this week, may you experience the greater glory of God in your finances, in your health, in every dimension of your life. Let there be glory. Let God appear to you. You people, you are so blessed. Thank you so much for watching. I'll be back on Wednesday for the midweek service. Do join, please. Make sure you connect. Let's continue to hear the word of God. And thank you so much. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for taking your time. Let me speak the grace. Remember, to love God is to obey His word. Go ye therefore and be doers of His word. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of the Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Ghost be with you, people of God, always. Till we meet again, you are highly favored. Your servant in the Lord, Prophet Lloyd Gangata. Thank you for watching. People of God, you are so blessed. Thank you.